Let me consider this example. A cantilever beam supported at end A, span is 3 meters, carrying a UDL of 10 kN per meter. The free end is B. Let me solve this. Though it is not required to find out the reaction and moment, but let me proceed. To calculate the reactions, it is a summation of forces, vertical forces equal to zero to have the system in equilibrium. When I consider that Ra equal to 10 into 3, I need to multiply the span to the load UDL. So 10 kN into 3, so the 30 kN acting upwards, and using equilibrium again, moment equilibrium, I can find out the moment at A. So that is 10 into 3 into, that is 10 into 3 is the force which will be acting at the mid span, and into 1.5 about A, moment about A. So totally 45 kN per meter. 45 kN meter, alright. So let us revisit the sign conventions for shear force and bending moment. When the shear force, when we find out the shear forces and bending moment, we'll be considering a section XX for a cantilever beam. We will be considering that XX section from the free end. Okay, so when I consider that section XX somewhere in the in between the length of the beam, if I consider the left part of this, then upward direction of forces will be positive and the downward direction of the forces will be negative. If I consider the right part of the section, then it is vice versa. I mean, downward forces will be positive in the right side of the section and the upward forces will be negative. Okay, similarly, bending moment, when I consider XX section towards the left of the section, if they are causing a counterclockwise moment, then it is positive. Towards the right of the system, if they are causing clockwise, then it is negative. Okay, let me proceed to find out shear force now. Okay, fine. I need to find out the shear force at A and B so that I can draw a graphically represent that in terms of a diagram. Again, consider a section XX between AB as shown in the picture. Okay, now we are considering this section X from the free end. Okay, so as we have defined shear force, it is a summation of all the forces, vertical forces. Let me say now towards right of this section, towards right of this section. Okay, towards the right of section, there is a UDL here, 10 kN acting over 10 kN per meter acting over x distance. So if I say the vertical force 10 kN into x, when x equal to 0, that is location is B, x equal to 0 will define FB is 0. When x equal to 3, that is at A, when I shift this section to location A, x will be 3 meters. So I can say the force, shear force is 10 into 3. So that is 30 kN. Okay. The direction of force towards the right of section, the direction of force is downwards. So it is positive. Okay. So how to draw the shear force diagram now? Very simple. Extend the reference points A and B vertically downwards, then draw the beam AB, then mark shear force points at A and B, then draw a line connecting them. Okay, so that is how shear force, initially draw the beam AB. So at A, shear force is 30 kN, at B it is 0, so draw a line connecting those points. Okay, so it is a positive shear force we are having in for this section. Okay, so we can also observe that the shear force along the length of the beam is varying linearly. So please, you know, we should keep this in our mind. Similarly, let us see the bending moment at B and A, and let us draw the bending moment diagram. Let us again consider a section xx from the free end at a distance of x. Bending moment, by definition, what is it? Bending moment is summation of all the moments caused due to various forces towards the right of the section. Let me say right of the section. Okay, so right of the section, it is causing clockwise moment. So I'm considering a negative sign here. So 10 into x, that is the force which will be acting at the mid span, into x by 2. So that is 10 into x by 2, that is 10 x square by 2. That will be the moment, minus 10 x square by 2 will be the moment acting at this section. At x equal to 0, that is location is B. When x equal to 0, moment becomes 0. And at x equal to A, the length is 3 meters. So when I substitute x equal to 3, when I will get minus 45 kilonewton meter. Okay. For my sake of drawing easier, making it easier to draw the bending moment diagram, I can also find out the value of bending moment at x, y, 2. So that is 1.5 meters as well. And I can also observe that the bending moment, what we can see here, it is a parabolic variation. Okay, it is a minus in the sense downwards, we'll get downwards below the beam, we'll represent below the beam, then 10 x square by 2. It is a parabolic equation. So let us draw a bending moment diagram. Very simple, extend A and B, then draw the beam AB. Okay, since the value of bending moment is minus 45 below the beam, so I'm drawing the beam little more closer to SFT. Represent the values of a bending moment. At B it is 0, at A it is 45 kilonewton. I have not represented the negative signature sign here. The reason is it is already shown in the negative side of the beam. Okay, so draw the line connecting them. Now line connecting between 45 kilonewton meter and B will be a parabolic line. So I need to draw it as a parabolic line. So here it is, bending moment is negative. You need to mark this in the diagram. Thank you for watching.